Originally, after doing some research, I recognized the role that our state police actually plays with ghost guns. So for, you know, those that might not know, individuals are able to buy guns in parts. And because they're in parts, they're not collectively already put together. They're not required to do background checks, or they're not required to have serial numbers on the actual pieces. So many individuals are getting around that loophole, and they're essentially flooding our streets in Philadelphia and across the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And just last year, President Biden issued regulations to tighten that up, where any piece that is supposed to be used for a firearm would now require a serial number, but also require a background check. And here in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, we have to do our own regulations around the issue. So that's really what I pressed the state police on, to get a better understanding as to what are our plans here in Pennsylvania, what is the timeline? Because again, as I said, they are flooding our streets. Back in 2018, police in Philadelphia recovered close to maybe 100 of those type of guns. But fast forward to 2022, we've seen a 2,600% increase, with close to 500 of these type of style guns being confiscated. And this challenge is, you know, only adding to our detrimental numbers when it comes to the homicides that are increasing in the city of Philadelphia. So gratefully, we saw Governor Wolf take a step closer to addressing those issues. But now we're looking at our new governor, who is looking to do the same thing, to, you know, tighten those reins up so individuals aren't able to get around those loopholes when they go to the gun shows, or when they're ordering things online and, you know, committing crimes and things of that nature. So it was a great conversation, and hopefully we'll see some progress in the next couple of months.